Hey Centennial, I'm Lauren Ridley.
And I'm Graham Blevins.
Before you tune in to watch season finale of The Law, we want to tell you about a new show taking place this fall.
That's right. Once a month, you'll be seeing more stories on Centennial, Roswell, Atlanta, and even the world.
And don't you worry, The Law isn't going anywhere.
Today, we'll bring you a very special presentation on the Jamie McHenry story. Without further ado, Centennial, welcome to The Rise.
A late April evening, Christine and Jim McHenry cheer on their son's lacrosse team as they move closer to the state championship. The Centennial Knights are strong this year, with ambitions of going all the way. For the McHenrys, the season is not what they expected. Jamie McHenry's number 8 jersey sits on the sideline.
He was fabulous son. I was proud to be his father. He was always a great kid to have around.
Spring break, my 7th grade year, I took him to Miami. And we started there, we got down to Miami, we were loving it, we were like having fun, just looking at all the Miami girls and everything.
Jamie's parents were in North Carolina, over 700 miles away.
That's when we got the phone call that no parent ever wants to get. The most horrible phone call.
When we get to the road, I cross, and then I remember I turned back and I said, hurry up. And then I turned back around and I started walking. All I heard was a bang.
Jamie was hit by a car and killed on April 3rd, 2013.
I know a lot of people probably couldn't point to the single worst moment of their life, but I certainly can.
In the days and weeks after, the McHenrys struggled to understand.
One of the biggest problems is that you want them to go on. You want to keep caring for them and having them in your life.
I just felt like, you know, we can do this. We just have to get through these hard times. And by forming the Jamie McHenry Foundation, I feel like that's kind of our way of continuing to take care of him.
In the looming shadow of tragedy, the McHenrys found a way to honor Jamie by giving back to the community and the sport he loved so passionately.
I remember Jamie always being as a person who was a lover of all sports, but lacrosse was something that kind of drew his interest in such a way that was like unparalleled to any other sport.
Lacrosse was just his passion. He loved it and loved watching it, loved playing it. And he was pretty good at it. Had a great shot, quick, and it was a big part of his life. And ours after that.
After his accident, we started thinking of ways to give back.
Through the Jamie McHenry Foundation, the family embarked on many projects, such as funding a new lacrosse bounce back wall, new gates at the fortress, and scholarships for lacrosse athletes in high school and middle school. Their most prominent fundraiser is a 5K race in Jamie's honor.
We have it at Centennial High School. It goes right through the parking lot of his elementary school, Hillside Elementary.
And what better name for the race than Jamie's lacrosse nickname?
Rocket Shot was Jamie's nickname in lacrosse, and he was given that by his teammates and by his coaches based on the velocity of a shot on goal. He had this wicked kind of wind-up where he, you know, and people would duck.
The McHenrys have sponsored this event every year since the accident, and it continues to bring the community together. ...2018 would have been Jamie's senior season.
You know, we have a really good chance of making it deep, and you know, everything we're giving, like on and off the field, is definitely for Jamie, without a doubt, and he's with us 100%.
Jamie still inspires and motivates the Knights lacrosse teams with state championship aspirations.
I went number 8 because Jamie was also number 8, and I owe like everything I know about lacrosse to him. We, now in high school, we're like doing really well, so I think it gives me and all my teammates something to work for and play for him.
In a time of tragedy, it is important to remember who they really were.
It was crazy. Jamie was nuts. He didn't care, but he didn't care in a good way. You know, he didn't care what people thought, but he was such a nice and genuine person.
Charisma is something that really helped him, especially when pursuing his love for sports.
And he wasn't afraid to make new friends. Like, he was open to everybody.
And by choosing to live for them every day through our actions.
I kind of feel like we have to, you know, we have to live for Jamie, and that's where that whole concept of the live for Jamie that the kids came up with their wristbands and the support of the community has been just, it's for me, it's very healing and helpful.
Live for Jamie.
Elevate! Spielberg, baby! How are the kids?
For 2 years, the AV3s endured the musings of a mad doctor. For the last year, they have grown and become a team. They have elevated the program and become the loft. Now it's time to pass the baton to the AV2s. Farewell, AV3s. You will be missed.
Yeah, some days I feel unfazed.
How'd you enjoy season 3 of The Law?
Why are we standing against the wall?
Why not?
What was the question?
How'd you enjoy season 3 of The Law? You heard it here, folks.
I thought it was very funny.
It was exquisite. It obviously just deserves an Academy Award.
It was really good. I enjoyed it.
You heard it here, folks. It was exquisite. Season 4.
Last Jedi was the best Star Wars.
Shut up, dude. Season 4, I'm gonna...
Waterfalls and cool stuff. I'm an artist, I'm a rapper, I'm a producer, an entrepreneur of sorts. I guess if you would classify it as genre, it'd be kind of like alternative hip-hop. I feel like every song that I've written within like the past year or so has been like about my ups and downs and everything in between. My music's just me. I started making music when I was 14. I kind of like dabbled in every genre that I could, couldn't really find like a solid sound up until last year. Now I'm 21 and it's like weird to like see how far I've come with it. I'd hold myself back a lot because of like my anxieties or my insecurities, and I think once you overcome stuff like that, it becomes a lot easier to accomplish your goals and dreams. Just do it and don't give up, and as long as you're persistent with it and you have the drive and ambition for it, then you're golden.
Hey Centennial, it's Lyric Wright, and this week on Book Talk, we're going to be going over The Sun Is Also a Star by Nicola Yoon. My favorite part about this book is that I can't believe you actually believed this was Book Talk. It's actually Word of the Week, and the word this week is sun. The sun is the star in which the Earth orbits around. Speaking of which, I wonder what the weather is today.
What's up, Centennial? It's Molly Heiser, and I'm your host of Yesterday's Weather Today, where we predict weather you've already experienced. Today is Monday, May 14th. It's sunny with a low of 66 and a high of 91. It's a great day to eat lunch with your friends. Now to Jackson to confirm the weather.
It is sunny. Spell cappuccino.
C-A-P-P-A-C-H-I-N-O. Good?
C-I-N-O. There's an I, it's an I, not an A.
I don't think that's true.
You spelled it right, by the way.
Did I really?
Psych! What year was coffee invented?
That's not
like
a
when
year.
It was invented by Starbucks.
No, I drank coffee this morning and I'm grossed out. You ruined my day.
If caffeine is addictive, does that make coffee a drug?
If caffeine is addictive, that makes coffee a drug. So if coffee's a drug, that makes Starbucks a drug cartel?
If coffee's made from beans, then does that make it bean soup?
Wait, you thought this was a Coffee Island ad? Bean the voice. Man, that was cringy.
I'm so confused.
That's so stupid.
Why would anyone watch this?
You're watching The Loft.
The nerve, the audacity, the unmitigated gall to echo such blasphemous nonsense. Just blasphemy. Absolute blasphemy.
Hello and welcome to Midway Through the Day. I'm your host, Troy Johnson. Today we're going to be interviewing Sarah Willis. Sarah is the drum major here at Centennial High School. She plays the flute, and she's just really excited to be here. How you doing, Sarah?
Doing all right.
Doing all right. That's good news. First off, I want to know, what's the relationship with your father like?
I think it's pretty all right, you know. Mm. He's a cool guy. Mm. I like him a lot.
You play the flute, right? Okay, cool. So what is the flute any different from, like, the saxophone or clarinet?
Yeah, a little bit.
Well, the flute's silver and the clarinet's, like, black. You guys know the clarinet. Squidward. Moving on. Next question.
No, she's my sister. No.
Like, the girl who sings about her boyfriends.
Bro.
Spell Centennial.
S. The first step to be cool is to show off your dumbness.
I'm done.
I'm mermaid.
Yes, my boy.
The water.
Delicious.
We were so sick and tired.
Outly to be wished.
Spielberg, baby. How are the kids?
Henry looked sad.
I'm lagging, bro.
Sorry!
I think Fortnite is overrated because PUBG is better. Fortnite's free, and nothing that is free is ever as good as something that you have to pay money for.
Highly, highly overrated among little freshman boys. They don't deserve to be called men. They are little boys who run around jumping on their rockets, and needless to say, it is incredibly overrated.
Now, I think The Loft is very underrated because, you see, as a person who has enjoyed analyzing and studying film for a long time, I think a lot of people miss some of the deeper meanings, you know, behind The Loft. You know, when you really look at it, you know, Jahari and the Safari is about a person trying to find themselves. And also, you know, a lot of people complain about the parts that goes like, you're watching The Loft, but you see, that's actually a psychological trick that filmmakers play on you because, you see, by subtly reminding us that we're watching The Loft, it makes us not want to stop watching The Loft.
I think The Loft's underrated. I think there are a lot of teachers who don't show The Loft, I say looking into the camera. I think a lot of people don't watch The Loft. I think a lot of people try not to appreciate The Loft, even though everyone works really hard to put a lot of really interesting and cool segments together. I think it's underrated.
Self-promotion.
Yes. Shameless self-promotion, indeed.
All right, the whole school's about to hate me, all right?
Gravy, can you tell me what 2 + 4 is?
8.
That is incorrect. Diego, please tell me what 4 + 4 is.
Oh my god. Huh?
Is Kanye here?
Good morning.
Okay. Does anyone know where Post Malone is?
Asar.
So you on the computer?
Why would he ask me a question like that? Why would he ask me a question like that? He sees me on the computer. He sees me. He sees me. I'm on the computer. Yeah.
So you watching Dora?
He sees I'm watching Dora. He sees Boots. He sees the monkey on the screen with the Yeezys on. He sees it. I'm watching Dora. Yeah. Man, just get out. Just get out.
Episode, so I'm back at Woman on the Street. Let's do this. Hey, what was your favorite part of school year?
The beginning.
That's nice.
I would say my favorite part would be the pep rallies.
Just love learning. And you know, the last week is super exciting. Like, it's so much fun just like to be at Centennial High School, like to be a high schooler.
Lunch.
Nachos for lunch.
Anybody else? Favorite part of the year?
Oh, no? Pep rally. Actually, another.
My favorite part of the year was when I first joined the track team.
That's nice.
I got to meet all my new friends.
That's a good one.
Math.
I like don't have one. Like right now, like I'm ready for it to be over.
That's a nice. I like that part. It's over. That's a nice part.
I like passing my classes. That's always great.
That's nice too.
I've done it.
No, I told them that.
Mr. Bigner, I finally finished my segment of 2 weeks.
Christian, I told you, you can't make segments for The Loft anymore.
But Mr. Bigner, it's a really good segment.
Look, you know what? I don't have time for this.
I guess that counts as a yes.
Why did you do that?
Because I did.
Honestly, when she took my phone, I was offended. Like, it hurt. I was confused.
I took his phone because I wanted to. I don't even know why I got so mad.
I can't do this right now. Cut the camera.
This is all just too much. Come on. Stop.
I think we have a game to play, Sarah. Mm. Are you ready to play Guess That Lil?
Guess That Lil.
Rappers that we had, so I guess that Lil.
Yeah.
Okay, Sarah, we're going to be playing Guess That Lil. Your objective is to distinguish between the fake rappers and the real rappers.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to read off these names, and you tell me if they're real or fake. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Number one, Lil Moonrock. Real or fake?
Fake.
He's real. That's a real rapper. Yeah. I don't know any of his music. We just pulled these off the internet.
Okay.
But a real rapper. Mm-hmm. Next one, Lil Skies. Real or fake?
Still fake.
Still real. Very much so real. On SoundCloud making music. Crazy. I don't know. Lil House Phone. Real or fake?
Real.
Real. Yes. Very real. Actually, all of these have been real. None of these are fake. Because the truth is, modern day rap is terrible and we got to fix it. So this is actually the last episode of Midway Through the Day. So this is a big moment for everybody, because
season finale.
Oh well, I mean, after this is finals week, so there's nothing really else to do. So yeah. All right, thank you, Sarah. It's been a blast. It's been a.
This class is a film and editing class where we get the opportunity to film, produce, and edit videos for The Loft, which is a school TV show.
There's such a wide array of things you can do.
And I just saw there were so many opportunities for me here.
Because you have to plan out the segment over the whole week and know what you're doing.
I've learned how to use a variety of equipment in different ways.
Editing software that I haven't used before.
To make things like Jahari and Safari and Max on the Facts.
There's like hype videos and teacher features, student talent, just to like show the essence of Centennial, but then there's also like kind of ridiculous segments put in, like my segment.
You realize how many different talents people at Centennial have.
I like how this class is really free.
I also like the community around here.
It's like a big family. It's kind of like a place where I can go and be myself and be creative and have that relaxing free time, but still learn and learn about things I love to do.
Even if you're not really into film, there are so many things that you can do here.
So if you even have the slightest interest in doing that, I would definitely join The Loft.
It's a heck of a lot of work, but it's a heck of a lot of fun too.
How's the weather this week?
This week, yes.
Or no, like today. Where did all of the... Mr. Beekner!
Top drawer of this thing in there.
Arnold, can you unscrew this? Those are dead! Who's using a lock?
Did you put new batteries in this?
Bruh, it turned right on.
Right.
We do have a thing on the
more,
over there.
More right, my right. More. Closer to the camera.
Here. That's why I can't use it during CSPN.
That's your clear. Actually, that looks really good. Don't do the beginning again.
Go us! You figured it out.
Hello Centennial, I'm Molly Heiser and I'm your host of Yesterday's Weather Today, where we predict weather you've already experienced. Today is Tuesday, May 15th, 2018, and sadly, it's my last time predicting the weather this year. It is partly cloudy with a 40% chance of rain. It's a high of 77 degrees and a low of 64 degrees. Now to Max to confirm the weather.
It is sunny.
Thanks, Max. According to the Weather Channel, Friday there's going to be 100% chance of rain and it's going to be very humid. That's all we have for you this year, Centennial. I'm Molly Heiser.
And I'm Max Abel.
And you've been watching the final episode of
Yesterday's
Weather Today.
We'll be right back.
Centennial.
I'm Max.
And I'm Takaira.
And you're watching CSPN.
The boys lacrosse team got beat on Wednesday in the semifinals, bringing their season to an end. It's been a good year for Centennial Sports, from the football team winning their first postseason game in 15 years, to both lacrosse teams making deep runs in the state tournament.
That's all we have for you this week.
You've been watching CSPN.
That's all for Season 3 Centennial. Thanks for watching The Loft.